Good morning, troopers. I'm Alexi Barra.
And I'm Isaac Pedregon with your weekly recap.
Attention students, if you haven't already heard, Eastwood has started a new supper program where students can now enjoy a free, delicious, warm dinner before heading home at the end of the school day. Dinner will be served Monday through Thursday from 4 to 5 p.m. in the cafeteria. The program is open to any child ages 1 through 18. Adults can purchase a meal if they wish to join you. For more information, see Ms. Luz Fuentes in the cafeteria.
Students, if you're taking an AP course, you must pay for your tests no later than November 1st. You can make your payment with Ms. Chinoya in the business office located in the administration building.
Also, any students who would like to challenge a test that is offered by College Board, make sure you pay for the test and take the receipt to Mr. Carrillo or Ms. Torres as soon as possible. The sooner you take your receipt, the sooner they can register you and ensure that you have the correct study materials that you will need in order to be successful on your test.
If you have any questions, please stop by the AP office. Seniors, UT Austin McCombs School of Business will be in the theater during 7th period today. Cornell College will also be in the Go Center during 9th period on Monday, and on Thursday, the University of Rochester will be in the Go Center during 3rd period. If you're interested in attending, please see Mr. De La Fuente for a pass for the day you would like to attend.
Troopers, unite your two passions, faith and athletics, to impact this world. Fellowship of Christian Athletes will be meeting Thursday in room 906 during second lunch.
Alexa, can you believe homecoming is already next week?
Are you kidding me?
You heard right. Homecoming season is already here. Tickets for the game will go on sale Monday, October 14th in the business office before and after school. If you wish to purchase tickets during lunch, you can do so with Ms. O in room M109.
Homecoming Dad's tickets will be sold for $25 each during the week and $35 at the door, so get your tickets soon.
Speaking of homecoming, show off your spirit and be ready to wear your PJs on Monday to be a part of the Breakfast Club.
Tuesday, dress up as your favorite decade for a trip back to the future.
Wednesday, are you a bench warmer? Will you be a mathlete or an athlete?
Thursday, join the Baywatch and dress in Hawaiian attire.
And finally on Friday, shine brighter than the Friday night lights and show your trooper pride by rocking your blue and gold.
I know we're all excited to show our school spirit, but let's remember to always stay in dress code.
Looks like it's starting to get chilly and it's starting to finally feel like fall. I don't think we'll have a problem with dress code next week since we can expect a cold front. Today we will see sunny skies with a high of 67 degrees and a low of 47 degrees. Make sure to dress cozy for today's game as the temperature will drop throughout the evening.
Speaking of tonight's game, the varsity football team will play Eastlake at the SAC at 7:30 p.m. Make sure to make your way out because your cheering and chanting helps motivate our team.
Cheering and chanting does have a large effect on our team's success. Volleyball will be playing here tonight at 6:30 against the Sleda Indians. So if you can't make the football game, come out and support our varsity volleyball team. Hey Alexa, I heard that you won the first district championship of the year.
We did. We are officially back-to-back district champions after defeating El Dorado on Tuesday 18-0. On Monday, we will be playing our bi-district match against the Jefferson Foxes. We will then advance to area on Wednesday.
Congratulations, guys. Also on Tuesday, our Eastwood volleyball team girls defeated Horizon in four sets and are now 22-13 overall and 11-1 in district.
Wow, our trooper sports are on fire this year.
We sure are. Well, unfortunately, troopers, that's all the announcements we have for this week's recap.
Have a wonderful weekend.